Dextorf, and I'm heading home, and it's time for Sunday drives. Let's fix this camera. It's not as right. Okay, so yeah, this week what I wanted to talk about is all the different kind of styles of shooting video. You know, I struggle, and I've often spoken about it on my videos, like I struggle to get lighting right and color right, and do I do lots of cuts, and do I, you know, what sort of content do I do? You know, I really have a hard time. So I'm always watching stuff to figure out like the best way that I can possibly make my videos so that they compelling enough for people to watch, at the same time easy enough to edit in the amount of time that I have. And then it's just, you know, dealing with day-to-day life and technology and everything else that just, you know, puts a lot of pressure and constraints and everything else. So I had watched this video this morning about how this guy was looking at teenage app. Hold on, I'm actually gonna have to look at this now. Right, I have to check something. Right, so there's this app called Tik Tok, and I think it used to be called Musically or something, but it's something that the teens are using right now, and they basically sing a song, sing along to music, or edit video to music. And it's only 15 seconds long, but some of these kids are getting really creative. You're never going out of style. Ooh, pretty baby, this world might have gone crazy the way you say. And what's so amazing about it is that in 15 seconds they are shooting some really incredible shots. I assume the app is actually giving them some functionality in terms of how they're zooming and stuff like that, but I'm not entirely sure like how much is them using their camera in really innovative ways, and which is them utilizing the app to do some really great effects. And I find this hugely impressive because we're all limited by the tools that we have at our disposal. I often say, you know, the camera that I have on me all the time is my cell phone. So I use it to make 99% of the videos that I make, because it's just there, it's on me, and I'm not a very rehearsed person, so I have to use my phone. So to see that these kids can edit the videos the way they are on just purely an app on their phone to music with such great impact and effect is just something else. So I'm actually going to give myself the task this week of making a video on TikTok, and at the same time trying to maybe replicate some of the effects, if it's not the app, both with my camera and with using Premiere to simulate some of the effects that are being done by these kits. So I'll literally screen grab and record these things and then edit from there. So I will get to that. What's impressive is that they're able to tell a story in 15 seconds. And that's just truly impressive to me when you think of how we're trying to tell stories that last 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 50, 20. I mean, there's these endless kind of stories that we're trying to tell. And maybe the lesson there is to not have as many, well, as long of footage. Maybe you do just need these quick cuts. At the same time, though, then you have Dan Mace who pointed out that, like, doing all these fast-paced cuts is actually like shouting like a drill sergeant at people, expecting them to understand your storytelling. So I think it's really about getting really creative about how you tell your stories. At the same time, doing something compelling enough that people are intrigued to keep watching your videos. Because I'm still not sure if these like long commentated videos that I'm doing are actually working or not. I'll be honest, I don't know. I'm not sure if it's like getting me the reach and the impact that I want. Because the truth is, I mean, I have very low numbers at this stage of my kind of YouTube game. And then the thing is, you know, is this standard video format even working? Should I not be on Instagram? And it's, I actually went hiking a few weeks ago and I actually filmed the entire thing actually in a portrait mode. And I was gonna edit it then, but there's no time kind of, there's, you know, it's not like it was a specific day of the year that was important. So I can edit that video and publish it, and I'll probably publish it on Instagram TV, or I think it's what it's called. But yeah, I'm gonna try and edit it and publish it there. I tried to do some great shots and tried to tell a nice story, so I'm gonna do it there. And I just wanna see what is the difference, you know, what channel will give you the viewership that you want. I'm not sure that I'm anywhere near getting paid for any of this. I would love to be, because it would allow me to focus on doing more design orientated stuff that people really want. But, you know, it's something I do as a hobby, and anything that you do as a hobby and you have passion for, you know, you should do to the best of your ability in the time that you have, and just keep kind of getting better than the next time and the whole thing. And I've taken some steps back in some of my videos. Gotta be honest, sometimes I just get the lighting wrong and then I have audio glitches and things like that. Hey, I'm sorry. I do try. I'm definitely keen to keep doing this and keep trying to get into the space where, like, people start saying, man, this guy's got great content. Man, this guy's telling great stories. And hey, how cool is it that he's doing it over here, you know? There's some amazingly talented guys, you know, and they, like, the Sam Calder, he does these amazing travel things. And then you got Casey, who just tells a great story and just has this rugged way of doing great shots. And then you got Peter McKinnon, who, you know, does great cinematography stuff and great photography lessons. And then, you know, you got some other great commentators, these gaming guys that are bringing in the numbers, and you got to go, well, they can't be wrong, because they really are doing a good job of telling a compelling story, and they're certainly making content that people want to watch. I watch vloggers, and I still think, look, the daily vlog for me, I personally think, is dying. You look at Ewan Olsen, and he has gone to kind of weekly vlogging, and he cuts it up in two parts, but he documents what he feels like documenting on that day. And he still seems to be doing fine, and he seems to be enjoying vlogging again. So I don't know what the right format is. It's definitely still trial and error for me. I'm looking for that sweet spot. But I'm very interested, at least, to knowing what sort of content you want me to make. So please, like, leave a comment down below. Let me know, like, what stuff that I've made maybe interests you, or what stuff you think you would like to hear from me. Is it a day in the life of? Is it collaboration, which some people have suggested to me, but I just honestly, I don't know who to collaborate with. So let's put it this way. If there's someone who you would like me to collaborate with, because you think there would be like a good, like, symbiosis, I guess we'd gel in that sort of way, then please do let me know. And I'm not shy, I'll reach out. You know, they can either go yay or nay. But other than that, please let me know what sort of content you want. And I'll do my best to make it. I hope you're having a great weekend. Happy Sunday. I hope you're excited about Monday. You know, I always am. And yeah, that's me. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, leave a comment, and stay cool.